Hello, this is the second part of the Next.js performance optimization series. In today's video, we're going to be looking at how you can potentially improve the initial loading time of the pages within your application. Take a look at this example application. It's a tool that helps you build shareable links with data attached that then get persisted into a cookie. The builder itself uses various different UI components, notably React Hook Form for managing the form state and Zod for client-side validation. The core part of the form is this context container component that drives out most of the data building. However, as you can see, we don't initially see this component when we visit the homepage, as we have no context to edit. Requiring this component from the start is a waste. We should only be bringing it in once we interact with the Add Context button. This is where lazy loading comes into play. Lazy loading is the strategy where you pick out resources that shouldn't block load and can be deferred until a later point. The example that I think React gives is, imagine you had a modal component that only shows up upon user interaction. It's pretty much a waste to require that component to be available on load, as the user may never use it. But you should always make the decision on your own application scenario if you want to lazy load or not. As some might argue, there's a user experience downside of seeing that component in that loading state and not being readily available from the get-go. In Next.js, there are two ways we can implement lazy loading: using dynamic imports or using React's own implementation with their lazy function and suspense boundaries. Dynamic imports from Next is essentially just a wrapper to React's approach. However, it comes with a few additional options that catered more towards Next as a framework, like the ability to not server-side render the deferred component. Right, so before I do the implementation, let's run a build just to see where we're at with the numbers we've currently got without it being lazy loaded. Okay, so 149 kilobytes of first load JavaScript and a bundle size, I always get confused with these numbers, but yeah, 21.3 kilobytes. I'm sure that is the bundle size. So, first thing we're going to do is we're going to get our dynamic import going, and we're going to get rid of our existing context container import, and we're going to come down here and say dynamic context container. Perfect, Copilot's got what we want. And we're also gonna want to do a loading. Yeah, we can go with that for now. That doesn't need to be anything fancy. And all we're gonna need to do is basically just replace the existing JSX, paste that in. That looks all good to me. If we do a refresh, oh, am I not running? No, I'm not running dev server. Brilliant. Done, perfecto. And we should just be able to demonstrate this. So if I add context, there we go. So we got that little loading flash, you know, half a second loading state, component resolved, and then more importantly, any new context containers at this point forward are just going to get the resolve value. So it's not like we get the loading state every single time. Once it's resolved, it's resolved. When I say resolved, it's the promise that this dynamic import is basically doing to the underlying component. So if we close the dev server and do another build now with the dynamic import being applied, we should see that those numbers have gone down. Perfect, and there we go. So we've gone down, was it 149? Kilobytes to 123 and 21 point something down to 4.75, which is great, which is good. That's what we want. That's pretty much it. We've successfully deferred our context container component and that performance hit. As I said in the previous video, it might not seem like much, but these values do add up over time. And it's sort of like, you know, a very small example highlighting the problem. As usual, be sure to subscribe if you don't want to miss out on future tips like this. The code used in the video will be linked down below for you to check out if you want to. Thanks for watching and have a lovely day.